How to make money from property. Property. It's one of your core asset classes and a super, super juicy asset class. Now we're talking about investment property. I'm not talking about your home that you live in. We already know that that is not an asset. So we're talking about what are the different ways that you can make money from this amazing asset class? Now, there are literally thousands of different strategies, so we're not going to go into all of them here, but I wanted to just spark some ways of you thinking, what are the different strategies? The first key thing is there's two primary ways you make money from property. One is called yield. It's the income that you get from somebody utilizing a space. And that's all property is about providing a space that somebody rents from you and you get paid income for them being able to use that space. And when you think of property as just space, you can go, oh, literally, that could be a tent, it could be a garage, it could be a yurt in the field somewhere, it could be an apartment, it could be an industrial unit, and you start realizing that, investment property is this whole bigger thing that maybe you thought. So one aspect you make money is through income, and the second is through capital growth, the increase in the value of that property. So remember, with every asset, there's two ways that it makes money for you. The income that it generates, the growth in its value, and those things together are your return on investment, the return on investment of that asset. So in property, when we're thinking about income strategies, the one that most people think of is buy to let, renting out an entire unit. It could be an entire house, it could be an apartment, it could be a single room in a space. But renting out is the traditional investment property strategy. You own something, rent it out. Again, it could be an industrial unit, it could be a garage or a car park. The next is you could actually rent out a room that is not in a place that you're in, or even maybe your neighbor's place, but in the service accommodation model. So as opposed to a long-term rent where somebody gets beneficial use of a space and you sign a contract and off they go, you could do short-term service accommodation. Service because it's furnished and you might provide some services. So think of Airbnb, booking.com. That's where you can take a space and utilize that. That gives you a higher yield, more income on a smaller space. You could take an entire house, and instead of renting it out as one unit, you could then also divide up and rent out each individual room. You could also convert, say, a dining room into another habitable space, and you could now rent out each individual room, and that is called HMO, or houses of multiple occupancy, where it's still a longer term rental where people would pay monthly, but maybe they sign a year or a 2-year contract like a buy to let, but they are signing a contract on a room within a property as opposed to the property as a whole. Really great strategy to increase your yield, your income potential on this specific property. You could also say, well, Anne, I don't own a building that I could use for HMO, I don't have property rent, but even my house is fully utilized. Could you create a unique space on things like Airbnb, bookings.com? Unique spaces are really, really popular with people to be able to use. You could literally pitch a tent in your garden. Do you have a bigger space with a lovely view? Could you build a tree house that people could come to? Pitch it as a unique experience, an outdoor opportunity, a writer's retreat. So don't get limited by what you think is a traditional model of property investment. You can also rent out somebody else's spare place. Many people have spare rooms, but go, or spare spaces that they aren't using. So you could collaborate with somebody else, maybe a neighbor, someone you know. You could manage the arrangement of finding tenants, and you rent that out both on the longer term, but also the short-term service accommodation strategy. And so that's really getting into the realm of understanding that you don't even need to own property to benefit from it. You can literally rent property and rent it out. And this is a super, super powerful strategy. Now, there's a fantastic masterclass by Tamron Sheriffs, who's an expert in the rent-to-rent model, and I highly recommend you go and check that out to truly understand. You know, if you're saying, I don't own the property, I don't have a deposit to buy a property, but I want to get income coming in, maybe the rent-to-rent strategy is for you, where literally you can rent a place, and it could be a single small room, it could be right up to a building, that where you rent out, you know, for HMOs, for students, but you don't even own the property. You just rent it to rent it, and you get the benefit from that. So I've just covered a few aspects of the income strategies around investment property. We'll do another blog on the capital strategies, but hopefully that's got your juices flowing and understanding why this investment class is so juicy, and also how you can benefit from it, and in so many ways to bring more cash flow into your life, which you can use to buy and pay for your other assets and accelerate your way to freedom. So my name is Anne Wilson, and if you're watching this anywhere over than at thewealthchef.com, head on over there, and in the comments below the video, I'd love you to share if you are already an investment property owner, if you're a property investor, and if so, what are your core income strategies, if indeed your strategies are income strategies. Because the more we share together, the more we learn and go, wow, I didn't even know that was possible. So be abundant, share, let us know, what are you investing in the investment property world, and how well is that working for you? And remember, your wealth is created step by step. Keep focusing on your freedom, taking actions, and most importantly, enjoy the life that you have now.